Okay, folks, it is February the 9th, 2015 at 5:40 p.m. And I just got this gem from the Lord while talking with my brother. The word okay knits together with the word no, just like the word yes knits together with the word no. The word okay and yes are parallel. They differ by 3 points exactly. And then they knit together with no in obvious fashion because they chain link at the center letters. So I just want to get that one on the board before I just leap into these gems I already wrote on the board. And then I got a bunch more from the Lord, like amazing ones. Just Holy Ghost speaking to me while I was at the gym, taking care of my body, which is the temple, of course, as we all should. But check this out, okay? We got room down here. As long as the writing is on the wall, that's all that matters, okay? Quality will come with when more people get on board with this and yada yada. But our job is to get it on the wall and spoken. So, the word yes, by divine ordinance, knits together with the word no. So that when you put the word or in between them, which divides by three, and you say yes or no, in three words, it all divides by three. Okay? And so here comes, look at this. Yes knits together with no, making 33 at the center. And then this is 30 in front, and this is 15 in the back. Yes or no divides by three. Okay? And what does that add to? That adds to 63 plus 15 is 78. Now, watch this, the word okay. The word okay does the exact same thing. And I told my brother in real time, I said okay parallels the word yes. And it knits together with no to make multiples of three. Well, I wasn't even thinking, I hadn't even seen this much yet. But look, look, again. The two letters in the middle make a multiple of three. This was 33, this is 39, famous NY, New York. And what's extra obvious about okay and no is they start with an O and end with an O. That's God's favorite letter to glorify the number three. Some people say these things back to back, just for fun. Okay, no. okay, no. You hear that all the time, it's just a perfect jam. But look, okay, and then look at this. Then the K and the A knit together to make 12 points. Well, lo and behold, that means this front of okay is 27, which is exactly 3 points different from yes. They differ by 3 points exactly. That is divine. So they're parallel. Yes is parallel with okay. So when someone says, you know, okay, what they're saying is yes, mathematically. And then when they say, it's awesome. Right? And you can say, okay. And then what confirms this is, you know, on computers you have okay and you have cancel. Or you have okay and you have no. Or you have yes and no. Like just any computer, like any Windows dialog box, it'll say yes or no. Or it'll say okay or cancel. Well, cancel parallels the word no. So you can do this. You can put okay plus cancel to make a multiple of three. I did it in my head. Know that it divides by three. And you can also, and then since yes is parallel with okay, you can knit together yes with cancel to make a multiple of three. Okay? I just put this Y with this E. I know this is 3, or 15 plus another 6 points, 21 plus 33 plus 12, 45, 60 plus 30. Wow, okay plus cancel is 90 perfectly. Like that's the most famous pair of buttons in Computerville. Okay or cancel. Yes or no, okay or no, yes or cancel. It's divine, okay? Everything is exactly the way it's supposed to be. Our job is just to put the pieces together and see the numbers. Okay, so look at that, that's beautiful. Okay, okay, no. Man, that's cool. And so, okay, no, is obviously just 3 points less than yes, no. Or no, sorry, it's got a 39. I remember, yes, 81, it's pure threes. It's 3 points higher because these center two letters were 39. 27 plus 39 plus 15 is 81. And don't forget, I mean, that's obvious because it started with O and it finishes with O. So it's really fun to say. Now you know why it's so fun to say that pair of words in six letters, no less, you know. Five letters, by the way, glorifies the number three as well with yes plus no because that is the third prime. Five is the third prime. But six, obviously, is a double three. And you hear this set spoken by people all the time. And they'll really drag out the O's because the O is the funnest part to say. He'll say, okay, no. Just like that. And see, it makes you laugh. When I say words that are like divinely, like mathematically perfect, I just start laughing. It's Holy Ghost. It's like, okay, no. My brother Jay knows how to say that like really good. It's like, we laugh at this sort of thing. Okay, no. Okay, no. In fact, I think, you know, Jay says that, you know, pretty often. Okay, no. It's just hilarious. Pure threes, three times three times three times three. So yes, parallels, okay. They differ by 3 points exactly. Okay? Or 27, and then this is, wait a second. That's, no, what's the whole word, yes, adds to like 49. What is okay in total, just for the record books? Yeah, Lord be praised. Yeah, of course. Of course, yeah. Okay is just 3 points higher than yes, because the grand total with no is 3 points higher. Duh. Yes is 49, okay is 52. See how they meet together with the word no? In obvious fashion. That's the chain linking gives it away. S plus the N, chain link, to make 33. The Y and the N, very famous, chain link, to make 39. Three strokes, you know? So, we solved okay and no. Perfect. Yes, 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 yes. Yes! And then the word yes all by itself screams out the number three. Because the Y is a plus one intro, and then the ES is 24 AAA. And so whenever you have a plus one intro, you can really drag it out. Especially the Y. You go, yes! And so, but the gold is in the ES. You haven't officially said yes until you say that ES. Up until that point, you're just yawning. Yes. There. Yeah, I don't know. There, I didn't say yes. There you go. Okay, now I got some big gems. I want to get the gems on the board, onto the camera. Then I got, I'm not joking, I'm at the gym, and I write things down. I grab a piece of notepaper from the counter and borrow a pen, and I write down the most amazing things. This is classic, you know, Albert Einstein wrote things on napkins. Just writing down, these are amazing revelations. So I want to get to these pretty soon. Like, probably one of my favorite ones on this list, well, the first one I got is that freedom equals 66 equals family equals happy equals blessed. Okay, I've known freedom divides by three for a long time, but I've got a lot of words memorized now, and I've got a lot of 66s memorized, so I know that family equals happy equals blessed equals freedom. Like, these are kingpin words. Happy, hello. Family, hello. Blessed, hello. Freedom. Wow, they all equal the same thing. That is a big, big revelation for mankind. Because the Trinity is the means to all of those things. Freedom, family, happiness, blessing. Okay. And we can teach this to all the children in all the schools at a young age. But the coolest one that I just can't hold back staring at it right now is the divine solution of white plus gray. I'm not joking. I was in the gym. I was wearing a gray top. I will show you the gray top. Where is it? Where's the gray top? That's the beauty of video. Here it is. A gray Nike tank top by Divine Ordinance. By Divine Ordinance, Nike equals my last name. Equals Derek. In fact, I feel led to put this on right now. You know why? Because I've got white underneath, and so when I put gray on top, we're going to have white and gray side by side. And that's the word I got from the Lord, is white plus gray. And I was shocked. And I was shocked because I was wondering about white and black for a while. And now I look like one of those kids on the playground that gets the singlet for gym class. Oh no. You know, all right, you guys are on the same team. And you guys are on the same team. Oh, we got the word of singlets. But this is what I was wearing at the gym, obviously with no white t-shirt underneath. And then I was wearing my white shorts. So I was wearing white and gray. But I got the gem from the Lord, white plus gray. So here I am wearing white plus gray. By the way, Nike divides by 3 equals my last name, Kubi. Nice little gem there, but white plus gray. Okay, it's a divine color combination. It adds perfectly to 120. And then the even cooler revelation on top of that, it adds perfectly to 120, chain linked in the center. And then the even cooler revelation on top of that is that gray knits together with black. Chain linked again. Like doubly chain linked. Like it's just screaming out. Look, I'm probably going to put this on the board and just detail it. Light, please. Focus, please. And then gray knits together with black, also in 9 letters. So white plus gray in 9 letters. And then gray plus black goes to 84. Both of these are all factor 8 numbers that divide by 3, and they're chain linked with 3s in the center. And then once you're at black, then you can go to gray, back to white, and the letters still chain link. And so I wrote that in here. I diagrammed it right here. You go from white to gray to black to gray to white. This is the definition of all black and white photos and all gray shaded artwork and anything that's been done with a pencil. Awesome! Like every black and white movie, every black and white photo, every black and white image, every black and white drawing. Okay? The shade goes from white to gray and then ultimately to black, and then from black it can blend through gray all the way back to white and back and forth and back and forth. Those three, it's a divine trio. White, gray, black. And shockingly, in this gym, it's obviously, those are the primary colors. Like then I look around the gym and it's like the entire gym is white plus gray plus black. Like all the gray, you know, all the machines are colored gray or silver. Silver substitutes perfectly for gray. It's 30 points difference. So it's the same offset from 3, differing by 30. So you can plug silver in between white and black, just like you had gray in there. It's totally divine. So in this gym, of course, there's all this gray equipment. All the equipment manufacturer divides by 3. Atlantis divides by 3. I wrote all these names down, but in the gym, there's gray, tons of white because of the lights and the shimmer off the metal, and tons of black, you know, for the paint. But I was wearing this gray top, these white basketball shorts, gray plus white. Even my shoes have, you know, gray plus white, and white plus gray equals 120. And then you go from gray to black, and then you keep going in a loop. So I'm going to write that one on the board. And then the first initials of both colors. Like, I was just writing all this down. In fact, it's probably a good thing for me to just, like, kind of do a scan of this document just so it's all recorded on video for historic purposes, what I wrote down while I was at the gym. And I'm there. Now I'm blocking the back from coming through successfully. There's Ivanko. I started writing things upside down, so I'm just going to scan this. You know, because as far as I know, I'm one of the few people receiving these mathematical. And then so I turned it upside down to write some other words down. Ivanko, alloy, the name of the machine that I was, and I was led by the Lord to go to the cables. I get one word, cables. Cables divides by 3. The cables machine. Because you can do every exercise for your body under the sun. And it's free motion. You know, the cables, it's called the dual cable cross. And I did the math on dual cable cross. In 3 words, it divides by 3 perfectly. While I'm in the gym, I'm just like, yep, here it is. It's called Free Motion. That's the brand that produces these dual cable cross machines. Free Motion adds to 120 perfectly. And even some of the exercises on there, like squat divides by 3. I did the wood chop. Wood and chop both divide by 3. And you can do the wood chop high to low. That divides by 3. Or you can do the wood chop low to high. And that divides by 3. And it's just like you're solving all this stuff in real time, having a pleasurable intellectual party while you're working out. So Atlantis is the other big name of all the weights in this gym. And I take note of this ordinance in my life because it is the closest gym to the place where I live. I go there all the time to take care of my body, which is a temple. I know the Lord has ordained my life. I'm very careful to record the details because I know it's all happening for the mathematical glory of Him. And the name of that place, as written on giant signage with the rules of the fitness center, like on the wall, I could see it while I was using the cable machine, is Willoughby Community Center Fitness Center. Willoughby Community Center Fitness Center. Yeah. That's actually what it's called. It's called the Willoughby Community Center Fitness Center. Well, community center divides by three, starting with two C's, which is three. And then Willoughby knits together with fitness and center to divide by three. That's, boom, the writing on the wall. It's like, that is the name. Remember, you always solve the name of the place. You always solve the name of anything. That's the king. You always solve the name of what it is you're currently in, where you're at, you know? So I write that down. I write that down on my little Willoughby Community Center Fitness Center equals three. What I'm saying is it divides by three. Ivanko, there's some light free weights there, the colored kind. Ivanko equals 72, a triple of 888s. Alloyed is the dual cable cross machine that I was led to use is made by Alloyed, which divides by three. It's 57. And there's also machines in that gym. Most of the barbells and the machines are Atlantis, which divides by three. And then the type of machine is called Free Motion, divides by three. And then specifically, the name of the machine is Dual Cable Cross. Every component divides by three. Alloyed, Free Motion, Dual Cable Cross. And the Holy Ghost just says to me, cables. It's the shortest, fastest word, cables, divides by three. Three plus three plus 12 plus 24. It's like, how many more threes do you want in the word cables? One more time. Three plus one plus two, which equals three. So three plus three plus 12 plus 24. It's like, yes, I will use the cables. Oh yes, Holy Ghost, I will. Like, 3 plus 3 plus 12 plus 24. 3 plus 3 plus 12 plus 24. It's like, yes, I will use the cables. That is wisdom. Because when you use the cables machine, not only is it super efficient, super flexible, you can do all your exercises for your whole body on that one machine, but you get excellent tensioner, you know, twitch, and like, balancing, and you can modify the range of motion. Super easily. You can tweak the angle that you're pulling and thrusting at, and with your legs you can blend movement, and so you can be creative and just do what your body feels like doing with the proper amount of resistance at any angle, and you just stay there at that one machine all day. I was there like a couple hours. It was just at least just working it. Mm-hmm. Just like, yep, I'm on the cables, man. Don't need anything else. It's like this is amazing. I'm just going to keep going off of what I saw at the gym. I saw a guy wearing a shirt on the front, North Lightning Football, but it was the back that I saw first, and I wrote it down immediately, because on the back, in giant capital letters, team, together, everyone achieves more. We've all heard that phrase, but now it's time someone solved it for the number three. Well, you can do it in your head. I did it in my head. Team, because I know team divides by three. That's one of God's favorite words. It equals the word mate. Team. God is a team. He's three persons. So team is 39. I know that divides by three, but now I'm curious about that famous phrase. Together, everyone achieves more. And I know more divides by three. That's like a kingpin word. Just boom, that divides by three all by itself. And then I add up the offsets of the first three words, and sure enough, it divides by three. Together, everyone achieves more. Divides by three. Just another gem. So I write it down. Write it down. And then come home and make a video on it. Share it with the world. By the way, sugar equals happy. You know that list I gave at the beginning? Freedom equals family equals happy equals blessed equals 66. Sugar equals happy. Sugar happy. And that's why the kids say that phrase. That's why everyone knows that phrase. Oh, he's sugar happy. Oh, the girls are sugar. They're really sugar happy right now. Every teacher knows that phrase, sugar happy, because the students like come in after like recess and they're just like, or after lunch, and they're just like, it's like, sugar happy kids, here we go. So sugar equals happy by Divine Ordinance. If you're low on sugar, you won't be happy. You'll be a grouch. You'll be like, nah, 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 nah. When you're loaded with sugar, you're just like bouncing off the walls, like cheerful. Okay. All right. I get all sorts of beautiful gems, encouraging words. I got this gem when I was doing leaping exercises, and I am typically the tallest person at the gym, and I typically, of the people at the gym, this is not like the Olympic training ground, folks, but of the people at the Willoughby Community Center, I can certainly jump the highest. And I love doing jumping, volleyball approach, spike, jump, leaps with a ton of energy. And I can almost get my head touching the ceiling. And it's just perfect. I can just ramp up. By the way, I wear my Sennheiser HD 201s. Here they are. Or no, they're over there. or they're in the vehicle. HD201 is like the favorite number in world history for the number 3. The word jump divides by 3. Jump equals 60, with the famous second letter dividing by 3 all by itself, the other 3 knit together being 3 plus 1s. Boom, boom, boom. That's the word jump equals 60, equals holy, equals pure, equals pray, equals believe, equals desire, equals all the heavy hitters in the story of God. To jump is one of the most satisfying human activities. And so I just like leap as high as I can, just like, you know. And I got this encouraging word from the Holy Ghost as I was doing my jumping exercises above the crowd. Above the crowd. So cool, so encouraging. Every word divides by 3. Okay, it adds to 141. I did the math in the gym. You can see I write these things down. Holy Ghost gives me a word, I write it down. Above the crowd. Adds to 141. And then specifically, I got the follow-up words. Jesus was above the crowd. Jesus is. Was and is have the same offset. And it knits together perfectly by divine ordinance with the word Jesus and God. So all these phrases divide by 3. Jesus was above the crowd. Jesus is above the crowd. God was above the crowd. Okay, God is above the crowd. Isn't that cool? And then you can put the word always in there, which is 3 times 3 times 3 times 3. Say, God is always above the crowd. Jesus was always above the crowd. Jesus is always above the crowd. Whew. Thank God we have someone who's above it all. God was speaking to me even at the gym, saying, Derek, everyone needs someone to look up to. Everyone in this life needs someone to look up to. Someone that we want the approval of. Someone that we want the praise of and the slap on the back and the we look up to them. We admire them. We, you know, it's God. Ultimately, it's God. Okay? But what a gift if you do have another human that, you know, you look up to that is also a great encourager and a great approver of your performing and just your own being. I get random gems from the Holy Ghost, like just cool, even romantic. Like, and then I, you know, the old white to gray to black trio that we got linked together with 3s, I discovered that going from white to beige to brown, you know, just similar, linkage of 3s. I got this gem that divides by 3 that is a very famous word. It's one of the most famous questions. Oh man, this is a romantic one. I just, out of the blue, do you love her? Divides by 3 perfectly. And it's stunning. Plus 1 knits together with the 2 plus 2s at the beginning of her. It's obvious. Do you love her? That's a very famous phrase. I mean, it's just okay. But I just get words from the Holy Ghost that scream out the number 3. So I'll probably put some of these on the table. I've mentioned most of them in the fastest way possible through spoken word. I just want to quickly get through the ones on the board, okay? This is all what we call rough stone cutting. We present all these things, get them on the internet, like get them shared with people, and then, you know, okay. So I was listening to worship music. The Lord spoke to me this morning and said to get worship music on my MP3 player, okay, before going to the gym. And so I did, and as I was listening to songs, I was just listening to that, you are holy, holy, holy. Jesus you are, Jesus you are. Shining like the sun. You are holy, holy, holy. God most high and God most worthy. You are holy, holy, holy. Jesus you are, Jesus you are. Whenever you say God is, that divides by 3. Whenever you say Jesus is, that divides by 3. So you make all these completely total worshipful phrases. Okay, so God, Jesus is shining like the sun. This is such a beautiful phrase. It adds to 207. Like just a set of words in and of itself. Anywhere in world history, in poetry, in arts, in movies, in worship songs. Just meditate, just take these 4 words right now. Shining like the sun. Whew. It's just a divine phrase, shining like the sun. Who is shining like the sun? Someone is shining like the sun. Jesus is shining like the sun. All the prophets that had epiphanies of the glorified Christ were near blinded. And God is shining like the sun. It's just like this phrase is reserved for God alone, shining like the sun. Like there is no one else shining like the sun, okay? So this is a very expensive set of letters in the mind of God because they belong to Him. He is shining like the sun. Whoa. Just occurred to me, this is bookended nicely with 33s. You can study this till you're blue in the face and get a whole bunch of interweaves of threes. The two last words divide by three. The is 33, sun is 54, equals love and breath and health and all the famous 54s. You know, so when you know, you can emphasize these two final words, shining like the sun, like they stand alone to divide. And then shining like makes 120 perfectly. The whole thing adds to 207, which is the exact same value as light in Hebrew, the first thing that God created. Wow. And here's the three Hebrew letters for light. 1 plus 6 plus 200 equals 207, which is 9 times 23, which is 9 times the ninth prime. It is king for the number 3, because 9 is a triple of 3s, okay? So. And the three digits add to 9. 2 plus 0 plus 7 equals 9. So the whole thing is 9 times the ninth prime. That's light. That's light. Like light that is the most important thing to man on earth, basically. Like, from a physical standpoint. The first thing God created, light. The 6 at the center, you know, is the most important. That's double 3. And then that's flanked with the famous 201 of world history. You know, the same value as the full birth name of the first man on the moon, the same value of Walt Disney's full birth name, the same value of Britney Spears' full birth name, the same value of Hans Zimmer's full birth name, the same value as the first man to fly faster than the speed of sound full birth name, Chuck Yeager, the same value as the name of the plane he was flying, Glamorous Glennis, the same value as the full birth name of the designer of the height of the Christ the Redeemer statue, the most famous statue of Jesus in world history in Brazil, Hector da Silva Costa. The same value as Bill Gates' full birth name and his father's full birth name and his grandfather's full birth name? The secret is out. It's all for God. It's all using numbers and names. Welcome to the party. Have some kids and give them the proper numbers. Oh, man. So 201, the famous 201 of world history, flanking a double three at dead center. Like, it's maximum for the number three. That's light. And so when we add in English, shining like the sun equals that value. It's worship time, as always. Okay? And so now, you can push it higher by turning it into a worshipful truth. Jesus is shining like the sun. What does Jesus is adds to? Okay? Jesus is 74, which equals Messiah, equals gospel, equals cross, equals the king, and a whole bunch. Equals element, that's how he takes the glory for every element in the universe, equals aurora, that's how he takes the glory for the aurora borealis, the northern lights, and the aurora australis, the southern lights. So Jesus is, bear with me half a second, Jesus is, as 93 plus 9 is 102. Okay, so this is 102, which is very cool, because that's the first three-digit number that divides by 3 perfectly. And God is, of course, equals 54, which equals love. Like, both of these two phrases are, of course, the kings. Like, okay. So Jesus is adds 102 points to this. This is going to blow your mind. It's blowing my mind. So when you say Jesus is shining like the sun, that adds 102 points to this to bump it up to 309. Hello. Like, does it get any better for the number 3? 309. And that is a triple of 103. And what is 103, my friends? Well, it's a three-digit all-factor 3 number ending in 3. And better yet, it's a prime number. Which prime is it? It is the 27th prime, which is 3 times 3 times 3. It literally is maximum when you say Jesus is shining like the sun. Boom. We've just proven it mathematically. You can't see Him unless He invites you in to see Him shining like the sun.
very few people are invited by God to pierce that veil on this side of heaven. But there have been people. And read the Bible. That's your best account of the glory of the resurrected Christ in glory. Book of Revelation is excellent, okay? So, and then when you say God is shining like the sun, you add 54 points on top of that to make it 251. That's three, wait a minute, that's not just 251, that's 261, pardon me. That is three times 87. Genius, because 87 also divides by three, and in fact, 87 equals truth as an added bonus for you. So you have a triple of truth, literally truth, truth, truth. So we just proved mathematically that God is shining like the sun. You see how cool this is? You see how worshipful this whole exercise is and the accumulation of all these words and all the knowledge and the memorization of all the numbers so that you can pull out incredible, incredible worshipful phrases and proofs in real time. So when I say God is shining like the sun, I've said the exact same value as truth, truth, truth. Wow. God is shining like the sun. Truth, truth, truth. I just proved it mathematically. And grade one children can do the math. But now you have to start memorizing things. Ah. Isn't that awesome? It's the definition of the most pleasurable game on earth. Easy to learn, lifetime to master. Man has been saying that from the dawn of games. Chess, you know, easy to learn, lifetime to master. That makes it a good game. Well, God, this is the most beautiful exercise of all time. Grade one children can do the math, but you'll be an entire lifetime. First of all, solving English, then you can solve everything in French if you want, you can solve everything in German if you want, you can get into the Asian languages if you want, you can solve everything in every language if you want. That's more than a lifetime. You won't have time. That's why, you know. But English is king. So join with what God is doing. English is king. Master English. Learn English first. And Hebrew, Greek. That's how I started. And then God called me into English and all the Latin. Anyways, okay. So now the word anointing. And folks, and then I want to preach to the glory of God on Benny Hinn. Because why do we refer to him as Benny Hinn? Because Benny divides by three and Hinn divides by three. God loves Benny Hinn like crazy. I love Benny Hinn. He's one of my favorite people on planet Earth. I love seeing the Holy Ghost move through Benny Hinn. Benny divides by three, Hinn divides by three. By divine ordinance, in nine letters, Benny Hinn divides by three. And then ministries divides by three. So altogether, Benny Hinn ministries divides by three. And anyways, this word anointing is so important, it's so big, but here's the solution of anointing. We have the plus one at the beginning being the most obvious plus one because A is one. It's totally, totally maximum. And then the rest makes the famous 72 a triple of triple eights. It doesn't get any better than this. Well, actually, yes, it does. That 72 is composed of a 24 triple eight at the dead center, flanked with N and T, which makes a double of that, 48. So you got 24 and double 24 to make triple 24 right there in the gold train of threes that follows the famous plus one introductory letter. And then ING is 30 points perfectly for the number three everywhere it occurs. So this gold train now becomes 102, the famous 102, which is Jesus is. The first three digit, all factor eight number that divides by three perfectly. And the reason God does that is because you can talk about the anointing's, you know, effect, for example. And then the S is always a plus one on the end. Or you can say, oh, there's multiple anointings happening at the church. They're praying for a lot of sick people. There's many anointings going on right now. So when you pluralize, you add a plus one on the end. This is what you call the steam locomotive effect. It's like a steam locomotive that pulls the gold box cars of threes. And it happens on either the front or the back, and it can happen on both. Okay? So imagine a train on the tracks that has an engine on the front, on this end, and it has an engine on this end. And the gold bullion box cars that are full of threes are in the middle. That's where you find the gold, okay? These letters are like introductory, you know? Okay, so there you go. We solved the anointing for the glory of Jesus and the Trinity. Okay, this is awesome. Now,
I was listening, while I was finding worship music, and just listening to songs, I listened to a Spanish version of You Are Holy, Holy, Holy. And the word Santo, they were singing the word Santo. Santo, Santo, Santo. Well, Santo divides by 15 just like holy. Holy is 60 divided by 3. Santo is 75. And this is just one example from the Spanish language, another to show you that all Latin languages have the same code. A equals 1 up to Z equals 7, and then just solve. One of the biggest first gems I got from the Lord when he was revealing this all to me is this Bible, which is my de facto go-to Bible currently. It's a King James Bible that is bilingual. And do the math yourself. Santa Biblia in Spanish equals Holy Bible in English. Oh, man! You got to be kidding me! I saw this on the shelf at a Christian bookstore. I did the math on Santa Biblia. I knew the math on Holy Bible. I was floored. I opened it. I saw the Spanish on one side. I saw the English on the other side. I said, I'm buying this right now. And buy it I did. And even the publisher, Holman, divides by 3. Holman divides by 3. Bible divides by 3. Publishers divides by 3. Holman is so loaded, it's ridiculous. 21 plus 27, 48 plus 15, 63. Boom, boom, boom. You know, even an H is composed of 3 strokes. And Holman Bible Publishers. There you go. But one more time. Santa Biblia equals Holy Bible. And you've seen enough. You've already seen enough to know that God is doing the exact same thing in Spanish, and the exact same thing in French, and the exact same thing in German, and the exact same thing in every language on earth. He's using numbers in all of them to point to himself in the most shockingly stunning and very creative ways. There it is on the cover. Santa Biblia in Spanish, Holy Bible. And then when you say the Holy Ghost in Spanish, it's Espíritu Santo, or something like that. I know that both words divide by 3 just like in English. That's just another example for you from the Spanish language. Of course, for example, like gold in Spanish, is that not oro, O-R-O, every letter divides by 3? Like, that's a big gem. You know how, I mean, now you start going into world history and how, like, okay, I'm not even going to start, but that's just a gem from Spanish. Okay. Now that this has all been solved, I want to write these gems from the gym, because this is really important, and these ones are really precious to me. The coolest one I want to write right off the bat is white plus gray equals 120. Chain links together to make multiples of 3. And then gray plus black equals 84. Also all factor 8 that divides by 3. Chain link together to make multiples of 3. And then you just keep going in circles. Then black plus gray starts coming around. Obviously it's making the same thing, but what I want to show you is that it's always bookended and it's always chain linked at the center with multiples of 3. In fact, this is really obvious because these two like centers divided by 3 is in fact doubly chain linked. It's in fact triply chain linked. Look at that, triply chain linked in the center. And then the bookends make the perfect cube of 3. Black to gray. Okay, so I even like the order of black first followed by gray, because you get 1, 2, 3 fold triple chain linking in the center, bookended with 27 triple 8. This is 18, double 9. That's amazing. Double 9 in the center, triple 9 on the bookends. It's divine. And then, of course, you come around again. So what I'm doing is I'm doing the full loop from white to gray to black, to gray back to white again. And showing you how every single pair of letters in the center and every single set of bookended letters, every step of the way, makes multiples of 3. Here, this is 25 plus 23. That's an average of 24 to make double 24. 48, and then the bookends make 12, which also, so this divides by 12, this divides by 12. Shocking. It's just perfect. This is the first time in world history that anyone solved the colors white and gray and black to the glory of the Trinity. That is so huge. That is so huge, it's ridiculous. You can go on a magic carpet ride through world history. Everything in this world has a color. Like, everything in world history, like here's...
Here's a cell phone that has white and gray and black, you know, on it. Like, just colors everywhere. World history, black and white photos, black and white artwork. It should not be called black and white photo. It should be called a gray and white photo, because that's the color tones that's going on. I mean, if it was just a black and white photo, it would be hard black lines and like blank, stark white. No, it's gray and white. It's a gray and white photo. It's a gray and white movie. It's a gray and white film. But the way the blackness is threes, and the infinite loop. Like, it's just amazing. That is so expensive. And then there's, and then count the number of letters and strokes. Here's 9 letters. Like, every combo on this board, of course, is 9 letters, which is 3 times 3. Like, this is maximum. You can count the number of strokes between white and gray. So gray has +1/3 and 13. Gray has 13 strokes. White has 7, 8, 9, 10, 14 strokes. Oh my goodness. That doesn't just divide by 3, that's 27, the perfect cube of 3, that's the number of strokes. 3 times 3 times 3. That's insane. So the number of letters is 9. The number of strokes is 27. Triple 9. Hallelujah. So how about gray and black? So gray was 13 strokes. How many strokes is black? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Glory to God, that adds to 24 perfectly. No way, which is 3 times 8. All for the number 3. Yes, Lord, hallelujah, hallelujah. We've just solved every combination of white and gray in the history of the universe, and every combination of gray and black in the history of the universe, and every combination of black and gray in the history of the universe, and every combination of gray and white, and all of it blending together, and all the black and white photos, and all the graphite sketches, and all the artwork done in black and white, and all the lead pencil, and the charcoal, and the... Oh, Lord, praise His holy name. I worship You, Jehovah. I worship You, Lord God Almighty. Oh, down on my knees. And for historic purposes, I was wearing this shirt, these shorts, and just... But anyways, the Lord said to me, white plus gray, or that was it, white plus gray. And just boom, the flood came. Whoa, and then you can substitute silver. I wrote down that you can substitute silver in for the word gray. Because gray is 55 in total, okay? White is 65, it's too beautiful. I mean, they differ by 5 points on either side of 60. White is 65, gray is 55. Hello, they differ by 5 on the other side of 60. Silver is 85. It's exactly 30 points higher than gray. And both of them start with +1 letters. Okay, the +1 is right there. White ends with +2, and the root, obviously, of white, we said that before, divides by 3. So it's really obvious what God is up to. The +1 of gray in the front, of boom, is together with the +2 in the back of white. Same thing with silver. S is +1 in the front of silver. The gold train of threes that follows silver all divides by 3. It is 27 plus another 27. Look at that. The word love is contained in silver. I love it, finding love in things. The gold train is 66 in silver. Okay. In gray, the gold train is 48. But they both start with +1 that knits together with the +2 from white. Okay. And also the +2 from black. So the K on the end of black is +2. Incredible. And then the beginning of the word white is +2. And the beginning of the word black is +2. Incredible. Incredible. And then the front and back, just mind-blowing. So silver, 30 points higher than gray, can easily be substituted in for gray everywhere it occurs to get multiples of 3 between white and silver. So a beautiful color combination is, of course, white and silver. Christmas time, you know, snowflake decorations. Or silver and black. I mean, that is every guy's favorite. You look at the, you know, modern decor for the modern, you know, most males love silver and black. My work area is mostly silver and black. Just think of most technology products. They're mostly silver and black. I will not hesitate to show you my work area so you can see. I mean, this video camera that I'm using is silver and black. By the way, there's a piece of abstract art that I'm creating on my table, which adds to 1, 2, 3 perfectly. We've just taken the glory for every piece of abstract art in the history of the universe. But silver and black, you know, silver and black mouse, silver and black speakers, silver and black monitors, silver and black, you know, gadgets, silver and black. I mean, it's just like the go-to. Well, and this video camera, this Sony camera that I'm using is silver and black, you know, and all the machines at the gym are silver and black. And that's where I got this revelation. Look, I've got an alarm here that's silver and black. It's like going, now you're into the treasure hunt, aren't you? You see how exciting this is? We're solving the colors of everything, because everything has a, you know, this is a little alarm, silver and black. It's like, you know, you're just like, everything is wondrous now. Pots and pans on the stove, silver and black. Can opener, silver and black. Cutlery, silver and black. It's like, there it is, folks. Automobiles, silver and black. You know, the Audi, you know, the Lincoln Town Car, it's like silver and black. So there you go. It's a divine color combination. Silver plus black is just going to be 30 points higher, just wherever gray occurs, so that's going to be 114. Up here, it's going to be 150. You know, just, there it is. Holy is his name. Holy God Almighty. Worship you. And then, oh yeah, I wrote down this little gem. Is it the first two initials of white plus gray? Add to 30, which divides by 3. And then the first two letters of gray plus black add to 9, which divides by 3. I believe that's communicated in what we circled no, it's not. So look, it just keeps getting better and better because the first and last letters of white are plus 2, and the first and last letters of gray are plus 1. You literally can circle things like this. Oh, look. And then you can stack these words on top of each other. Like, put the word gray underneath the word white, and you link up the G with the W and the E with the Y to make multiples of 3. In fact, they equal the same thing. This makes 30, and this makes 30. I promise you, the more you look, the more you see. We are staring at a divine combination. The gem has been dug up. Now you just dazzle it and turn it in the light for in eternity. And you'll keep finding more and more and more for the number 3. Just there. 30, 30, first two letters, and then, you know, gray and black. This is insane. Look at this. The G and the B knit together to make 9. And then the final two letters make a multiple of 9. They make 36, which is 4 9s. Same thing. Because black starts with plus 2 and ends with plus 2. You see the parallelism between black and white? And the more you look, the more you see. It's like, look, the two letters that divide by 3 in black are pitchforked right there. Well, the only one in white that divides by 3 is sitting right in the middle. So black literally complements white by having 2 there. This one's here. So if you were to line them up, 5 letters on top of each other, you got these 2 here, and then this guy in the center. It's like, and then the H knits together with the A to make a multiple of 3, and the T knits together with an A to make a multiple of 3, and it's just totally perfect. It's always perfect for the number 3. And then so, it's like you can just combine like crazy, and you get all the line, the first letters combining to make multiples of 3, the bookends to make you multiple of 3s, the chain links and center to make multiples of 3. We have solved every single black and white photo in the history of the universe. That's every anniversary photo, every silver anniversary photo, every 50th anniversary photo, every single wedding photo. This is beyond worthy. Every single wedding photo in the history of the world. I have a work of art on my wall. I'm just like, looking around the room, look, I did a piece of word art. Remember, word divides by 3 and art divides by 3. It's in gray and white. You know, love, the king. There's a piece of art for God, word art. In gray, you know, in gray and white. It's like, but think, I mean, wedding photos, anniversary photos, family photos in precious gray and white. And then they're putting silver frames, you know, with nice white, and everyone's wearing white, and it's silver, and it's all like white and silver and black and white and silver and black and gray and just all these combos. Some of people's most precious photographs are in these colors. Oh, this is expensive. So, wow. Okay, so that is huge, okay? So many things to say. So, Jesus, I already shared all the other gems on here at the beginning of the video. You can solve them all yourself, letter for letter, get the numbers and study them to infinity. Okay? I love the fact that the first gem, I was listening to the song, "Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom." That's one of my favorite worship songs for all time. By Michael Larson, CLA, we first heard that song. "Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom." And there is freedom in three words, divides by three, but freedom starts with the letter 6 and adds to 66 for the glory of the Trinity. Freedom. And there's three letters in it that divide by three, and then the E, D make 9, and the E and the M make double 9. And it just perfect. And it parallels the word family, which starts with the letter F as well, 6. Freedom equals family, equals happy, equals blessed. These are kings! Freedom! Everyone talks about freedom! But who's going to prove it mathematically to the world? Who freedom is given by? It's given by the Triune God. Jesus Christ gives freedom from sin and the bondage of sin. Wow. I'll just, you know what? It's the fastest thing to just leave it on here. Every community center you've ever been to in your life, community center in C plus C divides by 3, the Willoughby Community Center, Fitness Center, Sign divides by 3, Ivanco Weights divides by 3, Atlantis Weights, Alloyed Weights divides by 3, Free Motion, that's 120, Dual Cable Cross divides by 3, that's a machine I was working on. And it's very important that I mention these details, because that is basically when this gem of white plus gray came to me. I would love to, you know, above the crowd. That's a beautiful set of letters there. Every word divides by three. I'd love to get the full math on Jesus is above the crowd. God is above the crowd. Okay? Above the crowd. Above, I mean, that's so close to the word love. Above is, you know, contains, it's awesome. Above is so parallel to love, it differs by 9 points. It's 9 points less. It's 45. So both love and above divided by three. Isn't that amazing? And love came down from above. Like, it always comes down from above. It's always been coming down from above from the dawn of the universe. That's, God is love. But Jesus came down from above. Love came down from above. You know all these songs. So love is 54, above is 45. Both of those divide by 9, differing by 9 perfectly. And then so above the crowd. That's a phrase that belongs to God and Jesus more than anyone.